In this video, I'll show you how you can record your screen with Bandicam, just like I'm doing here. So the first thing you want to do is you want to download Bandicam if you don't already have it, and then you want to open up your Bandicam. Like when I just downloaded Bandicam and I wanted to use it, it was very difficult to use, but after playing around, I found that it was quite simple to use. It wasn't as straightforward as I expected it to be, but once I played around with it, I figured out how to use it, and it's one of the best screen recording tools, and I love it, and I'm gonna show you how to use it so that you don't have the same problems that I had when I just started using it. Okay, so one of the things that you want to do even before you record your screen is you want to do the basic setup. So let's go to general. So your Bandicam videos are going to be saved in your document by default here and in the folder called Bandicam. And you can change any settings that you want here, but the default setting is just fine for me, so there was no need for me to change them. And you can also see your videos from in here as well. So each time you make a new video, you'll be able to see it here, and then you can play it or double click on it to play the video. Or you can go in your documents in the Bandicam folder to see all your videos in there, and from there you can rename your videos. Okay, so next is the video settings. I found this setting to be really helpful for me and really crucial to help me record my screen. This one, you want to, when you first get into Bandicam, these won't be activated, so you want to click this checkbox. This is the hotkey for to record and stop. So if on my computer I set my my hotkey to control and plus print screen, so whenever on my computer, once I open Bandicam and then I press control and then print screen, it starts recording. And when I want to stop recording, I just press on my keyboard control and print screen. Now you can set this to anything you want it to be. Just click on it and then press. If you want it to be shift and enter, then you can set it to shift and enter. You can set it to anything you want it to be. And pause as well. So if you're doing a screencast and then you want to pause it, then you want to have something on your keyboard, which is a hotkey that you can quickly press to pause it instead of opening up Bandicam and clicking the pause button. No, you want to press something on your keyboard because it's faster, it's more efficient, it's smoother, and people won't see your screen, your Bandicam showing on the screen if you use your hotkey. So for my pause hotkey, I do control and F11. You can change it to anything. I think it was set by default at control and F12, but I changed it to F11. You can change it to anything you want. Just click on the key that you wanted to set it to and it will set. And then these two functions were not on when I was doing Bandicam. When I was first using Bandicam, these are important if you want to show your mouse cursor and if you want to show the click effects. These are very helpful to show the navigation. Just like now, you're seeing my mouse move around. That's because I hadn't enabled this. If I hadn't enabled this, you wouldn't be seeing my mouse right now. Okay, and then these stay as default. I didn't need to change them. And then the images, I didn't do anything with the images. They stay as default. So that's the basics for the settings. And then let me show you now to start your screen recording. Now that you've set up your settings. Oh, there's one more thing before. Oh, I can't edit this, right? But let me show you. This audio, it was set to 50% or something like that by default. So when you do a screen recording for the first time, your voice sounds super low and you might not know why, but it's because of this audio setting. Like I can't touch it now because I'm recording, but I've taken a screenshot of it to show you what it looks like. So all you have to do, you click on this microphone and you need to turn up your volume. So the volume was like at 50%, and if you turn it up at 85% or anything, 90%, 70%, then your voice will sound more louder and clearer. But maybe the first time when you use Bandicam and you record your screen, your voice will sound really soft and nobody can hardly hear you, so you need to increase your volume. And that's one of the things that I found to be really useful and I hadn't figured out, but it's really effective if you do that. Okay, so on your Bandicam, you might be seeing this screen when you go to home. So in order to record your screen, you have to select one of these options. Now, I usually go with the full screen because it's just faster and easier. Or you can go with the rectangle. That means you can crop your screen to wherever, however you want the person to see it. If you don't want the person to see your full screen, you can crop it to the image that you want the person to see on your screen. And then this one is device recording. You can record an external device such as your smartphone or your webcam. This one is for recording gameplays, and this one is if you want to record only your audio. So the first thing you want to do when you want to record your video, click on home by default and then click on full screen or any one of these options. But right now I'm using full screen. That's why you can see my entire screen. Click on the option there and then it will show you this that says this information here, and then you'll be able to start your video by clicking the button here, and then your video will start. And then you can click this button to stop it, or you can use your hotkey on your keyboard to start your video. You can press your hotkey to start your recording or stop it, and you can use this pause function to start and stop it. I hope this video was helpful regarding Bandicam and how to use it. You can also use just take a look at this cursor effect to update it if you wanna. It was fine for me by default mode, so I didn't need to change it. And if you have audios, this is where it's listed, just like the videos are listed here. If you record your audio only, you'll find them here. And again, you can find all your video files in this in your folder in your documents. I hope this video was helpful for you because I know when I just started out, Bandicam was confusing, but it turns out to be really easy. Please like and subscribe and also leave a comment so I can hear how this worked out for you. Thank you so much for watching.